Hi everyone, it's QuickyBaby and welcome back to World of Tanks, and Wargaming has released the Crystal Challenge. This is an opportunity for you to have to solve puzzles inside a maze, and then if your friends manage to screw up and they don't have all the time that they need to be able to complete the challenge, then you can have to give one of your crystals to be able to sacrifice your time in the dome at the end. No, that's a completely different program altogether. This is the Crystal Challenge in World of Tanks, where you are going to have to complete 10 different stages to be able to get discount on the prize, the Kampfpanzer 07RH, which I reviewed on the channel a couple of days ago. And so I'm not going to be talking about whether the tank is worth it, how good the tank is, because you could just go and watch that video from a couple of days ago. Today I'm going to be talking about all the challenge, exactly how long it's going to take you. And of course, and in true QuickyBaby fashion, I have taken all of the information and put it on an Excel spreadsheet where I believe it is going to be easier to be able to talk about. Okay, so I've broken down all of the rewards into kind of their base potential, i.e. equipment as to what you could sell or you could purchase the pieces of equipment for if they were half price. So the rewards are actually fairly nice. You can get yourself a total credit reward of nearly 1.9 million credits if you include selling the equipment as well. That's pretty nice. But considering it's going to take you quite a long to be able to get that, yeah, you'd probably be better in investing your time in elsewhere to be able to get credits. Nevertheless, it's just a nice little cherry on the top if you're planning to be able to get the tier 8 tank completely for free, because you're going to be able to if you've got a lot of time on your hands. The other highlights I feel are that you're going to get a day of premium after you complete stage 4. You can get yourself a day of premium after you manage to complete stage 7, and you're going to get yourself a day of premium after completing stage 9. And so if you're a free-to-play player out there, getting those days of premium is actually fantastic. I'm going to be attempting the challenge on my free-to-play account. Lots of extra content for Twitch and hopefully a little bit of extra banter along the way, and I get to have one completely for free at the end of it. All it's going to cost me is a lot of my time. But let me highlight that these days of premium, in my opinion, you should use them strategically if you are a free-to-play player. Try and pop them by completing the stage, i.e. completing stage 4, completing stage 7, and completing stage 9, right at the start of your next play session. So for example, maybe you could grind through stage 1, 2, 3, and then just get within an inch of completing stage 4 on your first day. And then when you're fresh, right at the start of your second day of play, pop that premium day and get to enjoy it while you're not kind of feeling all tired at the end of it and you feel like you're going to waste it. Other nice things to be able to pick up is that you can get some experience boosters, although they're only 50%, some crew training boosters, 200%, and some nice free experience boosters for 300%. Those will be very nice for trying to get through some of those tricky stock tanks. You can get some directives as well, but all in all, I'd actually have to call out Wargaming for being a lot less generous with the rewards that you get from completing the marathon. Of course, there's now stage 2 of the marathon, and Wargaming would argue, well, they kind of want to give those rewards to their premium customers, but you don't get credit boosters anymore. You get one less day of premium than you used to, and those credit boosters especially can be incredibly significant for all players to be able to make credits in record time. So the fact that you don't get those, it's definitely less attractive to be able to grind through this or even to just purchase it. Okay, so if you want to grind your way through this mission marathon, it's going to take you progressively more and more to be able to get through the stages. There are two ways of being able to play this mission marathon. One is that you can grind tanks that are tier 6 and above, and your base experience will be added up. It doesn't take into account your daily doubles. It doesn't take into account free your premium account status or any kind of bonuses you can get from platoons. It literally the base experience, the thing that you will see down the results screen, that you have. If you have an incredibly good game, then you're probably going to get like about 1,200, 1,300, and if you're going to have an average game, for most players it's going to be about 500, 600 experience. One important thing to mention, however, is that the experience doesn't count unless you finish in the top 10. So don't think that you can just YOLO rush into your opponents. You're going to have to finish in the top 10 for it to count. And this can actually be quite demoralizing when you get unlucky and you kind of finish 11th or 12th, where you haven't exactly had the worst game. You don't feel like you've played like a bot, but maybe there was just an unfortunate situation. And so that can actually be quite tricky for a lot of players, and it can severely negate the amount of experience that you will be getting. Your other way of being able to progress are to be able to do a series of missions in only tier 9 or tier 10 tanks. You're going to have to get 750 experience, 3,200 damage, and be the top 3 of your team. Then for stage 3, top team experience times by 2, and then they get progressively harder and harder and harder until you have to be top team of experience 30 times. Yeah, good luck doing that. I can't imagine many players, apart from those super unicorns out there, are going to be consistently doing that before they would have just grinded out the 50k experience. So if you're wondering what tier is best to be able to do the missions for excellence or whatever, the skips when you do tier 9 and tier 10 tanks, use this part of my Excel document and then you will see what tier I recommend to play, either tier 9 or tier 10 at all of the different stages. I personally recommend probably trying to do at least the first 6 stages using your tier 9 and tier 10 tanks if you're a very good player. If you're not, then you're probably just going to have to grind all of your way through. And it's a lot more chill to play at tier 7 or tier 8 than it is to play at tier 9 and tier 10 when everyone's tryharding during these mission marathons. Trust me on that. So now I'm going to move on to the part of the video where I try to calculate for all of you how long it's going to take you depending on how much base experience that you get. Now, one of the important things to remember is that I've tried to guess how often players are going to finish in the top 10 players on their team, kind of based on their average experience, because people who get less average experience are usually going to end up towards the bottom of the team list, and then that's kind of going to make it even harder for them to be able to progress. So for example, I have a multiplier that will mean that I think that somebody who only gets 100 base experience is probably only going to finish in the top 10 maybe 1 in 2 times, whereas somebody who gets 600 average experience I think is going to finish in the top 10 at least about 75% of the time, whereas the real hardcore players out there who average 800 base experience are going to probably finish in the top 10 at least 80 or 90% of the time. Consequently, this means that if you are a player who averages 100 base experience, then you are going to have to play 5,000 games of World of Tanks over the next 10 days if you want to be able to get this tank for free. Now, I've estimated that each game will roughly take 6 minutes to be able to complete, and so that means that you're going to have to play 50 hours every day. Yeah, not really going to work out for you. If you can get 200 average experience, then you're going to have to play for nearly 23 hours every day. So unless you can exist on an hour of sleep and then grind World of Tanks for the other 23 hours, then good luck to you. So if you average 400 base experience, you're going to have to play 96 games of every day. It's going to take you about 10 hours a day to be able to complete this mission marathon. If you average 600 base experience, which I do on my free-to-play account when I'm playing stock tanks, when I'm playing stock tanks, basically, I'd have to play the game for 6 hours every day, or 5.5 is probably a better estimate, to be able to get through this mission marathon. Now, if you're an excellent player and you're not playing stock tanks or you're playing some premium vehicles and you average 800 base experience every game, then you're going to have to play for about 3 2/3 hours. So quickly you can see that depending on how good you are, rapidly reduces the amount of time that you're going to have to play to be able to get through this mission marathon. And remember that this estimate is based if you only do the grindy missions, as you can see in this part of the Excel table. If you use some of the stages, especially earlier on, where I think that I'm estimating that if I was playing on my main account, I could do the first 4 stages in roughly about 2.5 hours, whereas if I was to grind, it would take me 6 hours. So I could shave off half the time by just playing well in my tier 9 and my tier 10 tanks compared to how long it would take me to be able to grind through the raw experience. So again, use this spreadsheet that I've given you to target what tier to play, try and play well, and maybe you can save some time. I think that it's not really worth trying to do stage 8, 9, and 10 with your tier 9 and tier 10 tanks. And if you're finding it tricky, give up on tier 9 and tier 10 and just focus on grinding. Maybe you can make a lot of credits in your tier 8 premiums. Now, considering that this premium vehicle is going to cost 60 euros if you want to purchase it in the shop without completing any of the stages, this part of my document shows you how much money you are making by just playing rather than actually skipping. So, for example, I think that stage 1 is going to take you just over half an hour. That can get you a 6 euro discount off the 60 euro price. So then you can make actually 10.5 euros an hour just by playing World of Tanks if you just bothered to complete the first stage. Then you can see it rapidly starts to diminish. Complete stage 2, you're still kind of working in World of Tanks for the equivalent of a 6 euro saving. Stage 3, 3.5 euros. Stage 4, you're down to 2 euros an hour. Then towards the upper end, it really starts to diminish very rapidly as you're investing a huge amount of time to be able to get less and less of a discount. So interestingly enough, this challenge is also exactly the same as the previous challenge. So if you're wondering how long the 122 TM challenge took you, that is exactly what the Kampfpanzer 07 RH challenge is going to take you. So if you manage to complete the 122 TM, then if you found it easy, then I guess the Kampfpanzer challenge should be easy for you as well. It's exactly the same as the previous challenge. And while it's not as easy as things like the TS5 was back in the day, that was a real opportunity to complete one of the easiest mission marathons ever. It's not quite as hard as the Object 274A was, but it's still pretty darn brutal. So finally, I want to give you all my key recommendations for how to try and complete this mission marathon if you want to undertake it. Okay, so look. The first thing is to realize exactly how long you are going to have to play. I know that I'm going to have to spend about 45 hours playing World of Tanks over a 10-day period. And so I'm going to stream every day for about 5 hours. Or if I don't want to play World of Tanks, I'll have to stream extra the day before. And then I can stream a different game the next day, or I can take the day off. You get what I'm saying? You have to plan it out. It's not enough to think, oh, I'm getting through all the stages really, really, really quickly. And then suddenly you realize that the final few stages take a huge amount of time. And if you don't have any money to spend on the game and you don't want to have to waste those 6, 12, 18 euros to be able to complete the final 1, 2, or 3 stages relatively, then don't get tricked into it. Your best bet by far is to be absolutely meticulous with the way that you plan your time for this mission marathon. Or alternatively, why not just play World of Tanks normally, see how many stages you can complete, and then figure out whether you think that the final 20, 25 euros is going to be worth it. For the last couple of challenges, Wargaming have also introduced Chapter 2, where you can go, and if you basically pay to be able to get the tank on day one, then you can manage to get yourself a discount for the Brunnenpanzer 3D style. There's not really too many good rewards until day 3, so I would firmly recommend if any of you really want to be able to get the Brunnenpanzer style and you don't want to have to pay any gold to be able to get it, that wait until Sunday, try and complete as many stages as you possibly can, and then purchase the bundle on Sunday, and then you're still going to be able to get the bonus reward for completing a mission daily for the rest of the campaign, where you're going to get yourself some nice crew boosters, you're going to get yourself some training manuals, which are very cool, as well as also getting yourself some days of premium. And if you finally get the star, you're also going to get yourself 15 hours of 50% extra credit boosting, as well as also that Brunnenpanzer 3D style. What I strongly would not recommend anyone to do is to waste your money buying it on either today, Friday, or Saturday, because the rewards are mostly starting from Sunday onwards, and if you play every day after that, you're still going to be able to get the style for free, and you can also probably end up saving yourself a lot of money and time by just playing on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, purchasing the bundle at the end of Sunday, then making sure, of course, you log in and actually play the couple of games in the tank to be able to do it. And personally for me, as somebody who has probably a job, but not the largest amount of time, but still feels like they want to get the tank, that would probably be the best way to be able to play through this mission marathon. Try and play a lot Friday, Saturday, Sunday, purchase the rest of the bundle, and then you can still play every day after that to be able to get the extra style for free. On the other hand, I want to clarify that these mission marathons are pretty much Wargaming thinking about how they can make you feel like you've invested time, so that the money that you have to spend later on to be able to complete the final few stages kind of feels as if it's a worthy investment, because you've already spent so much time playing already that what's the 6, 12 or 18 euros at the end of it? And while, look, that's a great deal to be able to get a tier 8 premium tank, you've also had to spend a lot of your time as well to be able to earn that discount in the first place. And just remember, if you've already got premium tanks, you've already got your ticket to be able to make lots of credits in the game already. Do you really need another German premium medium tank? Is it because it's just new? Are you trying to be a tank collector in a game that's very, very, very expensive if you want to try and be a tank collector? And at the end of the day, it's blooming pixels in a video game. And so if this is exam time for you, don't be an idiot. Go and focus on your study. Go and focus on your exams. If you've got a family, and go and invest some time in them instead of investing some time in the game. Unless, I guess, you're playing the game to be able to escape from them. I don't know. On the other hand, These mission marathons are excellent opportunities for free-to-play players who have got a lot of time on their hands right now. And let's face it, a lot of us have a lot of time on our hands considering we're pretty much locked in right now, quarantining. And for the fairly active World of Tanks player who plays, an hour or two every day, then you're going to end up probably completing at least 5 or 6, if not 7 stages. And then you can get a nice discount off a pretty nice premium tank. But once again, go and watch my full tank review if you want my full opinion on that. Anyway, ladies and gents, boys and girls, that was all you need to know about the Crystal Challenge, how long it was going to take you, how good the rewards are, and my tactics for if you're planning on attempting the challenge, where to invest your time, what vehicles to play, which stages to try and focus on, maybe your tier 9 and tier 10 tanks. Anyway, I hope that me doing the hard work was useful for you. If it is, give the video a thumbs up, but if you hated it, give it a thumbs down. And let me know in the comments whether you are going to be undertaking the Crystal Challenge. And if you have no interest in doing it yourself, but you have an interest in seeing an idiot like me try to attempt it on my free-to-play account, then I'm pretty much going to be live every single day on Twitch, starting from now, grinding our way through. Let's see if I can manage to do it a little bit quicker than usual this time. I like the way I'm always optimistic at the start of these challenges, right? Definitely not optimistic a few days into it. Anyway, really looking forward to seeing all of you there. And as always, thank you so much for watching. You've been epic, and hopefully I'll see you soon.